Thank you for coming out. We really appreciate it. It's Memorial Day weekend. We were a little bit nervous about people being gone out of town and doing things like that, but you came anyway.
But we're not grilling burgers.
No, we're not grilling burgers, no. They probably came because it's going to storm outside and it's better in here than without.
We're thrilled to have you.
But yeah, we are thrilled to have you. Thank you very much. We got a lot of songs to do for you, and I do mean a lot. We're supposed to be done by 8:30, but I'm not going to promise you anything. Seth's pretty cool about that. Thank you, Seth Longley, the guy that did all the announcements here. He set everything up for us, and he's just a great guy to work with. So,
do you remember when libraries though just had books?
No.
That is amazing.
We
everything that you do in this library.
We sat on logs out in the country.
Thank you.
All right. Well, let's get back into it here.
Looking for something that I like.
Well, that first song we did was called Starwood and Aspen, and it talks about being away from home a lot, on the road doing music, and we can relate to that, I think. And tomorrow, there's a line in there that says it's a long way from this place to Denver, a long time to hang in the sky. And tomorrow morning, about 4:30, I'll be hanging in the sky, heading back to Denver. And I'm looking forward to it, even though we've had snowfalls over the last couple weeks. And this song is another one kind of like that, too. It's written back in 1965 or something like that. And when John Denver was just starting out, and he gave this thing to a trio called Peter, Paul, and Mary. And they recorded it with their only number one hit their whole career. And this is it. All my bags are packed, I'm ready to go. I'm standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye, but the dawn is breaking, it's early morn. The taxi's waiting, he's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome, I could die.
Beautiful night.
So like it always is when I come here, it It's like a big family slash class reunion. I grew up in Kenton Lakes.
Schoolmates?
A lot of them were, yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, all the young look ones were my schoolmates. I grew up at Kenton Lakes and went to Simon Kenton, graduated in 19. So, any 74 grads in here? There you go.
Do you have a lot of dirt on Mark Cormack in
No, they show? Don't. No, they don't, because when I was in high school, nobody knew who I was. I kept a very low profile. Not on purpose, I just, nobody knew who I was. But the next year, Danny Daniels, who was the musical director there and the band leader at Simon Kenton, I played the trombone, by the way, and he called me up and he said, we're having something called the first annual Simon Kenton Country Concert. And I'd like you and a guy named Mike Riley, a lot of you know who that is, I'd like you to come over and do a couple of songs for us. And I said, okay. I thought, how many people could be in a Simon Kenton Country Concert, you know? Because the only audience I ever had up to that point was my mom and my dog. So I was pretty good about crowds at that point. And then I get into the gymnasium there at Simon Kenton, and there was 1,000 people in there. Scared to death. But somehow, we got through this song. There's a storm across the valley, and clouds are rolling in. The afternoon is heavy on your shoulders. But it's the light. I forgot to tell you to sing along on every song. And I don't care if you know all the words or not, it doesn't matter. Sometimes I don't know all the words. But I do ask one thing of you. Please make sure you're singing the same song we are. It works a lot better that way. Now, you may not be able to sing along with this one because I wrote it and you may not know it. That can be remedied, though. I do have CDs over here. And I wrote this thing about, oh gosh, I don't know. My kids were about 3 and 5 years old, something like that. They're much, much older than that now. And in fact, my daughter's sitting over there doing the CD table tonight, so oh, don't clap for her. Give her a big head. But anyway, I wrote this, and it's all about the fact that kids grow up so fast. Seth, the guy that was just talking to you earlier, he just had a daughter, and she's 9 months old now, and he can't believe it. I said, little, she's 23. Then you really won't be able to believe it. But anyway, this thing is called Hourglass. Little man. Thank you. My son will be 21 on June 22nd, and Hannah will be 23 on June 28th. So, it's been a long time since I wrote that song. Perhaps love is like a resting place, a shelter from the storm. It invites you to come closer. It wants to show you the more.
Down each, it was made from the
Dad would like that song. Neil. Yeah.
And you thought you didn't even know your grocery list from yesterday. You know, his parents.
Oh. Sorry.
This has been my theme song for the last 40 years, I guess. And in the last 4 months, it's kind of come true. Out in Aspen, and a friend of mine said, you ought to ask this girl to sing with you because she's really good. And I don't know how many times over my many years in the music business, people have said, you ought to have them play with you or sing with you. They're really good. And they get up with you and they're terrible. Too late then. But I said, are you sure she's really good? Yeah, she's really good. So I walked over just totally on faith, handed her the set list and said, whatever you think you can add to these songs, add to them. And so that's been about 5 years ago, like I said, and we
performed.
You never left. Yeah, we've been performing all over the place for a long, long time. From Lewisburg, Pennsylvania, KJ, folks. And this guy I met in the year 2000. I was at the Florence Yall Festival. Remember the Florence Yall? And I was going on stage. He was coming off and. I said, I know you from the Vineyard Church, right? He said, yeah. I said, my name's Mark. He said, my name's Rick. He said, anytime you want any fiddle playing or guitar, just give me a call. Well, he's changed his number 3 times over the last few years, but I keep finding him. And he's from Florence, Kentucky, on the fiddle and guitar and mandolin, Rick Marksberry. I love this song. I did it at so many weddings in the 70s and the 80s. And then almost 10 years ago, I did it in my own wedding too. Better put the capo in the right place, but it really sounds good. I'll drink your sweet wine. A million tomorrows shall all pass away ere I forget all the joy that is mine today. I'll be a dandy and I'll be a rover. You'll know who I am by the songs that I sing. I'll feast at your table, I'll sleep in your clover. Who cares what tomorrow will bring?
Yeah.
So I see a lot of people in here that I know tonight. And that was one of the scariest things about going over to Simon Kenton that night I was telling you about when we did Back Home Again. Because there were a lot of graduates were in there that had graduated before or with me the year before. And they didn't know I played guitar and sang. So here I am walking up to this microphone with 1,000 people in there, and they're all looking at me like, what's he doing here? So that was one of my problems. One of my many problems that night. Ready? Yeah. This is called I'd Rather Be in Calvary. 3, 4. Lonely and sad. distraught.
He's hanging with a girlfriend, having a great time.
But she's on a camping trip up in the mountains tonight, this weekend, so I don't think she's even thought about me for the last few hours. But I've thought about her anyway, and I'd like to send this next song out. Oh, about 1,200 miles west of here. Here it is. You fill up my senses like a night in the forest, like the mountains in springtime, like a walk in the rain, like a storm in the desert, like a sleepy blue ocean. You fill up my senses, come fill me.
Counter the shine below in the brand new.
audience participation time. Well, life on the farm is kind of laid back. Ain't got some old country boy like you can. Early to rise, early in the sky. Thank God I'm a country boy. Little sweet kind of life, never did me no harm. Raising me a family and working on a farm. See, they're all filled with a new country charm. Thank God I'm a country boy. Well, I got me a fine wife, got me old kid. When the sun's gonna come up, my kids on the door. Life ain't nothing but a fine, fine girl. Thank God I'm a country boy. Actually, I was on my riding mower in the front yard, and I got this inclination to write a country song. And so the best country songs are all about drinking and splitting up and those kinds of things, you know. Well, there's no drinking in this song, but there is a split. And this is it. Oh, I forgot to tell you, there's a lot of prayer in this song, too. Heard it said the Lord works in mysterious ways, and it's something that will never figure out. So when you came into my life, I raised my voice and prayed, and I'm sure you were what life was all about. Probably around September, I think. So, we're going to change gears here a little bit. We're going to do one of the most beautiful little songs I think I've ever heard. No, I didn't write it. I recorded it one time on an album, and the engineer said, that song is so beautiful in its simplicity. And I think he was right. That's a great way to describe it. And you can feel free to sway back and forth. Thank you. I got a lot of confused looks on that one. What's that?
Who feels like blowing up the TV right now?
Yeah. That's an old John Prine song that John Denver recorded on an album back in 71 or something like that. And I just love John Prine, so I wanted to do one of his songs. Now, this is another one of my songs, and I wrote this because one day I was sitting in my office, and I was looking around for inspiration, you know? And the desk just wasn't cutting it, and the computer wasn't doing anything for me, so I looked across the room, and there was a picture of my daughter in the fifth grade. Had this beautiful smile on her face, and so I started this song, and I was going, about 5 minutes to write. Well, I got that much and I stopped and I couldn't get any further. Then about 6 months later, I met my wife Sharon, and somehow the song just all came into being all by itself. And I sing this for the two ladies in my life, my daughter Hannah and my wife Sharon. This is called That Smile.
I'm not.
way, if you're looking for a, if you know of a dentist that's looking for a jingle, I think that song might be really good for you.
How many of you ever attended a John Denver concert? Raise your hand.
Oh, quite a few. Wow.
Well, if you did, and you did it back in the 70s, there was a guy that played the guitar for John. His name was Steve Weisberg. And Steve Weisberg was one of the most wonderful people I ever met. And we lost him about, what, three years ago? Yeah. And he taught me so much about music business, the reason why they call it music and business. And he was just a great, great guy. And I'm well aware that it's hot in here and that it's May, but I'm going to do a Christmas song for you. Because Steve wrote this song, and I've made it my business ever since he passed away 3 years ago to do this song at every major show that I do. And this is called Christmas for Cowboys.
Live by the sea and frolic in the autumn. Stompuff's gigantic tail, and noble kings and princes would bow whenever they came, and pirate ships would lower their flags when Puff roared out his name. Oh, Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea, and flourished in the autumn mist in a land called Anomaly. Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea, and flourished in the autumn mist in a land called Anomaly. The dragon lives forever, but not so little boys. Giant's rings make way for other toys. And one gray night it happened, Jackie Paper came no more. So Puff, that mighty dragon, he ceased his fearless roar. His head was bent in sorrow, and green scales fell like rain. And Puff no longer went to play along the cherry lane. Without his lifelong friend, Puff would not be brave. So Puff, that mighty dragon, sadly slipped into his cave. Oh, Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea, and thrived in the autumn mist in a land called Anomaly.
Too good after this song. Here we go.
gravity's ruin. They try to fix with a knife. What's pleasant in the darkness is plain scary in the light.
Reunion 40 in our 40th year class reunion. I won't be invited back. This is a song that I wrote about John Denver. It seemed like back in those days when he died, everybody was writing a tribute song. I wrote this. I got the news on October 13th. He died on the 12th, but I got it on the 13th. Beautiful day here in northern Kentucky. It was a crisp day with a blue sky and the leaves were turning. It was a gorgeous day. And so the thought of the bad news and the great day just kind of went over and over in my head, and a couple weeks later I came up with this.
One fine.
started out with that, and everybody at the bar and in the restaurant were looking at me mean. They didn't like that song, and I thought, it's only my first song, you already don't like me? What I forgot was that the next day was Super Bowl Sunday, and the Denver Broncos were going to play the Carolina Panthers. So Carolina in my mind didn't really go over big there. So I thought, I gotta do something before I get a beer bottle thrown at me. So I played him this song. He was born in the summer of 27 years. Coming home to a place he'd never been. That's yesterday, my heart again. Might say he was born again. Might say that I'm a key for every door. This is a song that John always ended his concerts with, and I love it. People ask me what my favorite John Denver song is, and I like all of them, but this is my favorite. The reason is because it is so biographical for me. Anybody that hears this song that's a traveling musician and away from home a lot, and sometimes all there is in your house or in your apartment, wherever you're living, is your guitar, your piano, whatever it is you have. And there was a couple times in my life when that was the case. And so I want to thank, again, Rick and KJ, Seth for his graciousness and setting all this up, my daughter Hannah for selling CDs. They are right over there, so if you get a chance, we don't need just checks or cash, folks. Through the miracle of technology, we have a little thing called a square, so you can buy it with a card. I'm so happy about that. So anyway, I want to do this last song for you. Thank you very much for being here, everybody.
I love to sing my songs for you.